Yo, what's everybody? We're back. Last time I left you guys off on a little cliffhanger after we defeated the bandits. No deaths. Let's keep it that way, hopefully. Yeah, let's continue on here. Huh. Wow. I remembered something.
I wonder why it is that you recall this place. You must be weak of heart. Each time I speak, it scares you so. Although the battle's at an end, do not feel too at ease. Well, anyhow, I am quite fascinated by this place. As far as I can tell, this is your first time here.
I must just say, I really believe that this lady looks like Lady Rhea a lot. And we don't see Lady Rhea's ears. Still. Let's see if she's been here.
Here? I dare say it would be impossible to have forgotten such a place as this. I must admit, I am unsure. Beyond the name and the strange feeling of familiarity, I can't seem to remember anything about this place. And yet, a great depth of emotions tied to that sense of familiarity. Like joy and sorrow, pain and love, and all things in between.
Okay.
If I was somehow here before, I wonder what to.
I am almost guaranteeing myself that this is something to do with Lady Rhea. If you don't understand it, I won't spoil it. I don't know anything. I mean, I don't know anything for certain, but it sure looks like that's what's going on. If you don't know what's going on right now, go watch the intro cutscene to this game.
Professor, I was wondering where you are. It's about time we headed back to the monastery.
It is time to depart. But know that time reveals all things. One day I will remember that which I have lost. Oh, by the way, it seems you've earned my gratitude. The thieves who came here are no more. I am not sure myself, yet I am grateful all the same.
Interesting.
In any case. You must become accustomed to my voice. If you fall down with shock each time I speak, that just won't do. Oh, you think you're standing strong? Of course you are. It was a jest.
She seems nicer. Out of nowhere.
On our way out, I had the chance to observe the Red Canyon. Did you notice anything, Professor? Of course. I expected as much. The area was covered in ruins, each more curious than the last.
I didn't notice shit.
They did not match the architectural style of any era or culture within the Empire, or across all of Fothan for that matter. That can only mean one thing. The Valley civilization must have flourished and fallen in the distant past, long before the Empire was established. Who do you think lived there?
It would make sense, a culture that doesn't exist anymore.
It's possible they weren't even human. Perhaps their remnants still influence this world.
So you have safely disposed of those bandits. I pray that their souls find salvation. But why did they target the students to begin with? We must further investigate the true cause of all that took place. Until we know more, I ask that you support the students and relieve them of any unnecessary worry. Good. I have high expectations for you. By the way, how was your time in Xanadu? Legend has it, in ancient times, a goddess alighted upon this world in that very canyon. For a goddess from the heavens, Xanado could only have been a temporary haven. Long ago, the divine Seiros received a revelation from the goddess. A gift to help guide the lost. The goddess is always watching over Fodlan from her kingdom above. However, in ancient times, the goddess graced this world with her presence and offered salvation to the people here. She is the mother of all life, the arbiter of every soul. I see. During your time here, I pray that you come to devote yourself to the teachings of Seiros.
Lady Rhea, I am sorry to interrupt. There is something I must ask about in regard to those bandits.
As you wish. We shall continue our discussion when next we meet.
A goddess? I have no memory of her. But then, I have no memory at all. Oh, how bothersome. It is as though I know, and yet I don't. Perhaps Xanado was my home back when the goddess walked the land. If so, what does that make me now? A ghost? No, that cannot be. I am most certainly alive. Perhaps some past regret is stopping me from moving on, and now I'm forced to stay with you instead. No, that's not it. I can't believe in such a meaningless existence.
She gets tired every time she has to think. Interesting. Yep, we are saving. So, both can attack, but their range is reduced.
Part 1. White Clouds. Garland Moon. Mutiny in the Mist. When the warm winds blow from the sea to the south of Adrastia, residents of Fodlan know that the rainy season is upon them. Before the heavy rains take their toll, young women hurry to pick the last of the white roses. The ivory buds are woven into garlands and given as gifts to close friends or potential lovers.
Okay, so we've got some new places to go. 2,000 gil. I believe this was called in this game. Or gold.
Professor, I have a new mission for your students.
Gotcha.
We have received reports that Lord Lonato has rallied troops against the Holy Church of Seiros.
Lord Lonato is a minor lord of the kingdom. He's been showing hostility toward the church for some time now.
A vanguard unit from the Knights of Seiros is already on its way to his stronghold, Castle Gaspar. Lord Lonato's army is nothing compared to the Knights. It is quite possible the rebellion has already been suppressed.
Even so, I would like for your class to travel with the Knights' rear guard to deal with the aftermath.
War zones are unpredictable. We do not expect you will have cause to battle, but be prepared for the worst.
Excuse me. You sent for me, Lady Rhea?
This is Catherine. She will be leading the knights whom you will be accompanying.
Nice to meet you. We've heard a lot about you.
Hello, Catherine.
If you need anything, just ask.
Hello.
She is one of our bravest knights. And that is no small feat. Only an exceptional few have what it takes to join the Knights of Seiros. This mission should prove useful in demonstrating to the students how foolish it would be to ever turn their blades on the church.
Well, goddamn, it's like that. Shit. Alright, whose birthday is this? Sylvain? Sure, I give flowers to everyone. You're welcome, brother. You're welcome. Playing online, let's see the behavior. Which activities on a given day. Cool. Yeah, 90% explore. Yeah, I don't see why you would ever rest. Oh, motivation, okay. This is like XP, I guess. This is skill experience. And I think exploring is just the best thing to do for now. Okay. Let's keep exploring here, shall we? So one of our... Oh, this is a hassle to get to. I'm surprised that they filled, like, every time you come back, there are new things to say with people.
Here to train? You really are as hardworking as they say. Huh, maybe the gossip's wrong. Hardworking people usually don't like to make a big fuss about it. Here to train?
Damn it. That's okay. Overcoat probably belongs to someone who often finds themselves in fights. Interesting. Okay, well, I know who that belongs to.
Catherine, hmm? Her skill is impressive, I'll admit. So is her sword. But I think she's hiding something. Nobody knows anything about her past. You should spar with her. She's strong. Stronger than you are, I bet.
Okay, I don't really want care for your mission assistance.
Something about this situation doesn't feel right. Why would a minor lord raise an army against a foe he cannot possibly hope to defeat?
Right, that's exactly what I was thinking.
Even within the Knights of Saros, Catherine is the strongest. By a large margin from what I've gathered. Why not seek her out as a sparring partner, Professor?
I would if y'all would let me spar. I would clap her. Easily. Easily.
I'm studying here so I could be the best there is, just like Captain Gerald. Do you think I've got it in me to be a top-tier mercenary, Professor? I'm going to work a lot harder than all the fancy nobles around here, I can tell you that.
I bet. Let's see. Where do we want to go right now? Who's in here? Ferdinand.
My central duty as a noble is to protect the common folk. I abhor those like Lord Lenato, who deliberately shatter the peace. Utterly disgraceful. You have a kind soul, Professor. Now I feel a little sheepish for showing anger and not empathy. I apologize for my impetuousness.
It's all good, Ferdinand. It's all good. White glove. Edelgard would own. Okay, so we're just on a fetch, not really fetch, but just gather quest this time around, this exploration day. What's up, Mercedes?
I've heard whispers about Lord Lenato. They say he's a very kind and gentle lord. Why would such a kind man suddenly raise an army? Oh, Professor! You were working late last night, weren't you? You shouldn't overdo it. A ghost might rise up from the well to get you if you stay up too late. Or so I'm told. I have a favor to ask of you.
Oh, nice. We can get a steel bow.
To be honest, I felt a bit lost here at the monastery. At a loss for what to do. Thankfully, a sweet young girl reached out and offered her help. I believe she's Sedit's little sister. Okay. Professor,
this month's assignment. Raising an army against the church? Really? Though it looks like we won't be fighting, it's still quite unsettling. My understanding is that it will all be subdued rather quickly.
Yes, that's the plan. Okay. Wait, so how do I do the... Oh, it's this button. Okay. Well, one thing is in order. Let's see. We need to... Interesting. Oh, wait, maybe over here? Yep. Y'all know who I'm looking for. Right, we gotta do what we gotta do, you know what I'm saying? You gotta do what we gotta do.
Really?
Relax. Alright, who's in here?
Did you hear? There's news of someone in the kingdom raising an army. The kingdom, the empire, the alliance. They do love a good war, don't they?
Yeah.
Spilling the blood of young men and women. And for what? Just to enjoy the horror of it? Would you be so kind as to do me a favor?
I mean, I forget what the stars do. Let's see, what's this do? Can I not check? Okay, I want to find out what that does. My magic's pretty low anyway. I'll just keep leveling up the sword.
The glory of progress.
I simply must thank you, Professor.
Nice.
There's no cake spilling.
Okay, so I guess we did that. There's another quest here. Oh, what's this? I wonder if we have to deliver, like, all of those now. But damn, everybody's just lost shit this month, huh?
Castle Gaspar, eh? I've been there once before, many years ago. It was by request of the son of that family. Christoph, I think it was. I have a request.
Okay, I can do that. Might as well go around and talk to people. It's one of them episodes, boys. Let's see, who's here? The nerd kid? Oh, Tomas.
Professor, I heard that you made battle alongside Catherine. Even among the knights, she is something special. A holy knight who is able to wield a hero's relic. Still, she can be a mite difficult.
Okay, there's something lighting up over there. So we'll go check that out. Yeah, really. Seems like there's an item we can grab. Okay, well, we'll go to Geralt. I thought it said the dormitory. But I guess I didn't pay enough attention. Just give that back to him.
Thanks for your help.
So we have some gifts. Use the gifts option to secrete your support points with others by giving them. This also increases motivation to return their own crew support points with gifts. Okay, so my girl, let me see if she would like any gifts. We are getting with her, if it's possible. It is happening, guys. She, Manuela, is best girl. Alright, lost items. Okay, I don't think it's with any of these guys. Gifts. Animals are cute things. Horseback riding. Weapon maintenance. Okay. I don't know. How would I know that exactly? Let's see. Is there any way to check? Support. Oh, so we have conversations. Oh, okay. So when we fight alongside people. And he has one with Petra. So I'm guessing that S is romance? But it doesn't look like we can, or let's see. Yeah, S looks like romance. So can we do that with Manuela? We can, okay. Great. Great, perfect. Okay, so I guess we'll just have their conversations.
Sometimes I wonder if your life could have taken you down a different path. If you had never met me and entered my service. You might have had a more peaceful...
A more tedious path. Inconsequential and spoiled rotten, like so many other nobles. Never. My duty to you is no mere obligation. I chose this. I had thought that would be obvious to you.
I understand you well. Better than anyone. But when I see you at the monastery, studying with the others, it makes me wonder what kind of life you might have had without me. That's all.
Such a life may have had its appeal. I thought I'd left my years of carefree innocence behind me. But I cannot deny that I find myself enjoying my time at the monastery.
I feel the same way.
That enjoyment, however, is only thanks to you. Standing by your side is all that truly matters to me.
I see. Then I won't speak of such things again. If it's really what you want, I'll gladly keep you by my side. The path I must walk is soaked in blood. It's a path that can lead to madness, can snatch away one's future, and can even take one's life. And the pool of blood at my feet is growing larger. Those stains can never be washed clean.
Please leave the violence to me. A leader must be seen as pure, above the fray. Allow me to paint the path that lies before you red with the blood of your enemies. I will do it gladly.
Okay, I think I will like try. I think I'm gonna cut this episode short and then we'll do more of this in the next episode. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time. Peace out.